One definition of who Graham Jackson was can be found in a most distinctive and singular business card. Favorite of presidents. His music was enjoyed by a half a dozen of them, most notably FDR Franklin Roosevelt. The story of Graham Jackson is one of perseverance, hard work, perhaps a little luck, and an amazing, immeasurable talent. Jackson arrived in Atlanta and became a band leader and musician at Bailey's 81 Theater, where there was a small but impressive Kimball Theater pipe organ. That was the springboard for a career in music that spanned seven decades. Band leader, his seminal syncopators were extremely popular. Pianist, with an incredible skill for improvisation and jazz. Organist, beginning when films were still silent, and also at church on Sunday mornings. Later, a teacher, and later still, world famous. One photograph in particular. The date, April 13th, 1945. The day after Franklin Roosevelt died. A grieving Graham Jackson, dressed in his Navy uniform and clutching his accordion, played Going Home as the Roosevelt funeral procession left the little White House in Warm Springs, Georgia, headed for the nation's capital. This was a photograph seen around the globe. His son, Graham Jackson Jr., tells us his father's relationship with Roosevelt started during Jackson's naval service.
It began before he was president. He was Secretary of the Navy. And he was introduced to Roosevelt by, I think it was Cason Calloway, who is father Bo Calloway, who owned Calloway Gardens. And another guy who was a statesman, very well known, Chip Roberts. And my dad was in the Navy.
Today, we would say that photograph went viral. Life magazine, the Associated Press, and UPI International Wire Services. It was seen worldwide as a vision of a nation's grief. Roosevelt's favorite musician appeared dozens and dozens of times at the White House in Washington, D.C., and the Little White House in Warm Springs, Georgia. In fact, Graham Jr. reflects on the house in which he grew up.
He had two houses together, the replica of the Little White House, and then the White House right next to it. There was a studio of music and art. So all of his paintings were displayed. All his utensils used them for painting were there. And we still have them in the house. People will wonder who the pictures of the people, the great portraits in the front of the house. And they'd be very puzzled. One was Beethoven, another one was Schubert. People expected a picture of my mother to be up there. Or my grandmother, or granddad. But he had musicians if you really enjoyed listening to.
As Graham Jackson's fame grew, so did his demand as an entertainer and a musician, even to national television, and that spotlight on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Suppose you sit down there and show us or let us all hear something that you used to play for President Roosevelt when you were down at Warm Springs with him.
All right, would you want it on the piano accordion?
Well, put it on both.
Thank you.
And there is evidence of that incredible skill for instantaneous improvisation, even live on national television. As son Graham Jr. tells us, his dad was plenty busy.
He could have church in the morning to play for, go to play a luncheon, play for dinner at a restaurant. He would play at the restaurant at night and entertain. And yes, many times he had to travel after that gig. But he always made it back in time to play for church.
The Graham Jackson influence spread far and wide. Not only national fame on television, profile pieces in Life magazine, and of course nightclub appearances. He made an impression on Georgia native John Clark McCall Jr., who was surprised during a 1971 visit to see a movie at the Atlanta Fox Theater.
Graham appeared without my knowing it as a pre-show organist. And I don't recall anything being said in the movie listing about him playing that night. And I honestly don't recall the film, but I can guarantee you I recall Graham Jackson. He was a strikingly handsome man. He was a gifted musician. And I've never seen anyone at an organ who could turn their head while never missing a single note. It was a grand 15 or 20 minute performance. He had an intimate knowledge of the organ, and that was very evident in the way he played. And then down he sunk into the pit with a glowing light around him, and the rest was history.
As a matter of fact, Graham Jackson played some of the greatest pipe organs in the world, including a concert invitation to perform at the Grand Court Organ at the Wanamaker Department Store in Philadelphia, one of the largest pipe organs in the world. You see Graham pictured here with Graham Jr. and Graham Jr.'s brother Gerald. Graham Jr. recalls his teacher father was a loving father, but strict.
And do my chores, then practice after chores, and be ready for to perform anytime, anywhere. And know how to talk to people, be gracious and appreciative. And people will remember you forever. When I saw the reaction of the people around him, of course I wanted to learn music. But I didn't think it was that hard because he made it seem so simple.
Years pass and memories fade, but dust away some of that fade, and one finds out quickly that Graham Jackson was one of the most famous and influential musicians Atlanta has ever produced. Here are just a few of his major accomplishments in a life of great music. While in the Navy, he sold more than $3 million worth of war bonds, more than any other individual, even the celebrities, during that time of World War II. His seminal Syncopators band was a leading jazz band of the 1920s when Jackson established himself in Atlanta, and later the group became known as Graham Jackson and His Orchestra. And he was among the first to broadcast live on radio in the late 20s and the 1930s. Organist at his church, at clubs and restaurants, and at the Fox Theater. Improvisation? Play off the top of his head? He was brilliant. No greater example than his album Solid Jackson, recorded on the Wurlitzer Pipe Organ at the Byrd Theater in Richmond, Virginia, for the prestigious Westminster label.
I think most of these cuts were one takes. And he did it on a bare bones amount of audio equipment as well, which again shows you the revelation of his genius and his flexibility as a musician and as an entertainer.
No greater accolades about how great a performer was Graham Jackson than this January 3rd, 1932 review of a Jackson performance at the Atlanta Fox. Now, fast forward and imagine. It's the 1960s, the segregated South, and yet Atlanta's most beloved and famous musician was a popular black artist heard by hundreds of thousands in concerts at the Fox, on radio leading his band, and at Johnny Reb's and later Pitty Pat's Porch restaurants. Graham Jackson Jr. recalls his father's words about the mix of both glorious and difficult times.
Be men. Keep yourself honorable. Truthful. Don't have to bend over backwards for anyone. But show kindness. Show love. It will all work out.
Graham Jackson was an Atlanta giant in music, known the world over. Today, the Atlanta chapter of the American Theater Organ Society remembers and honors the great Graham Jackson, and with this performance, establishes the Graham Jackson Scholarship for a deserving music student at Stevenson High School. Since Jackson's influence included his music on the theater pipe organ, we now present the Grand Page Pipe Organ. And please welcome the president of the American Theater Organ Society in his return performance at Stevenson High School. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Mr. Teddy Gibson.